CAT over ZAT being around the corner. This particular video is basically to help you how to prepare for ZAT exam. I'm Patrick. I have scored rank 1 in ZAT 2016-17 twice. So familiar with the ZAT exam paper. So I do run courses for CAT from last more than 10 years, 11 years. 20% of my students were preparing for ZAT and XLR, passed from XLRI. So you can look at my residential and the online courses on this particular website, prep.patrickandre.com, or look at these numbers to contact. Now, the pattern of the paper, if you look at it, the difference is the decision making section. So they have the con section, con in a DI. They have the verbal section. This is purely verbal and critical reasoning, and a decision making section. GK is a separate section. GK is not considered for cutoff. So basically, try to focus as much as possible on these first three sections, and do GK, but not focus so that you lose out on your other course. Now, when you look at it, there is 0.25 for wrong answer, and there's also negative mark for not attempting, but more than 8 questions on it. So that may vary every year, but overall, we can make out 27, 26, and 21. 0.05 is right now very small to consider. If you're looking at anyway XLRI, you have to anyway attempt a lot of questions. So anyway, your negative marks for not attempting will not be much. There is no logic as if you are comparing with CAT, there is no logic section out here, pure logic section. Decision making will have a few logic question, base question, but not much. Now, if you look at XLRI, the cutoffs are for BM 96% for male, 95% for females. Okay, for HRM, it is lower, 94% for males, 93% for females. Also, if you look at a cutoff for BM, the con cutoffs are higher. Whereas in HR, the con cutoffs are lower. That's how you can compare it to. In, as a matter of fact, in verbal, the verbal, so in HR, the verbal cutoff will be like slightly higher. So this 2018 cutoff will follow the same thing, verbal, con, and decision making. The con cutoff is higher for PM. That's how it works. Now, coming to the type of con questions, I mean, there are DI. DI has been a little bit varied as far as ZAT goes. If you go back to the past ZAT papers, you'll see there are different type of DI questions. There's data sufficiency also in the ZAT paper. So just go through it, be comfortable. High weightage for geometry, so be comfortable with geometry. Right? So, but practice like a CAT. Normally, if you know CAT and you practice like a CAT, I think it should suffice. These are the various topics. If you look at, there is coordinate geometry, two questions out here, but the weightage may keep on changing. Okay, there's no specific idea of the weightage. How to prepare for the ZAT? I'm a quant. The quant is very important if you're looking at very high percentiles. So if you get a lot of quant correct, there's a chance that you'll get overall marks will shoot up and you may get a higher percentile. So normally people with higher percentile are the ones who are good at quant as far as that is concerned. But that doesn't mean that people who get cut off, people who clear the cutoff are people who are good at quant. I mean, you can still be weak in quant and still clear the cutoff and get a call. But if you're looking at a 99.9 plus, then quant is important. It's similar to CAT, the con section, and can be solved easily by using alternate methods. We'll look at a couple of questions how to solve. Difference is a little more technical. I mean, you may require a little bit knowledge of maybe equations or x plus y the whole cube or something on that, which in CAT, you need a basic 10 standards. So taking a couple of questions from ZAT 19 to solve, to just understand, if you look at this sum, this actually looks complicated. But it's actually very simple. You can do it orally also. The gold ingot is in the shape of cylinder, is melted into a molten metal into a conical ingot. So if you convert a cylinder to a cone, if you know the formula, cylinder is pi r square h, cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h. So one cylinder, you can make three cones, okay, because dimensions are same. Now, height of each cone is half. If you halve the cone, that means you can make double of it, double the number of cones. So, the moment you halve the height, the volume becomes half. So, you can make double the cones. And circular base is 1/5. The moment you make the base 1/5, the volume becomes 1/5. You can make 5 times the cone. So, if you look at the total number of cones that can be made is 30. You'll directly get the answer is 30. But you have to understand it. The conceptual understanding should be there. It's not that you can directly solve it. But if you understand it, you can solve it really fast. Okay, let's look at one more. If you look at, they've asked sine BAC upon sine BAD. If you notice properly, BAC is smaller than BAD angle. Angle BAC is smaller than BAD. So automatically sine BAC has to be smaller than sine BAD. So if it's smaller, that means this ratio has to be less than 1 or whatever. So look at the options where the numerator is smaller than the denominator. If you look at the options properly, you'll realize only D option has a numerator less than denominator. AD is smaller than AC. So automatically D is the answer. Only D option is where numerator is smaller than denominator. You will directly get the answer. Coming to verbal, RC becomes important like the CAT paper. A lot of weightage on RCs. But you also have critical reasoning, which is important. 5 questions is important out of 26. So be aware of critical reasoning. So reasoning based questions are more important. People do remember that for its vocabulary based question, because the vocab questions are a little difficult. But there are not many questions. And maybe one of questions you can get flummoxed because of a difficult word. But otherwise, I think you can solve the vocabulary based question without much. So don't focus too much on vocabulary and grammar. Do a little bit, but not much. So focus on reasoning, focus on RCs. Those are the major part of the paper. So as I said, focus on RC and critical reasoning. Read a lot of articles, or RCs, read a lot of articles. Articles will help you to understand better. Also can provide a few poems, because last year if you look at poem-based RC, there have been past where poems have come. So you can look at poem-based RCs, read some poems, try to understand the language. Critical reasoning will require extensive practice, because critical reasoning people normally don't do when they prepare for CAT. It's a new topic, so if you can do extensive practice, that will help. Vocab and grammar are too vast to be prepared, and the weightage is low. So I would not recommend you to purely do vocab and grammar and spend too much time. Do a little bit, but not much. But when you read a lot, okay, automatically it will definitely help you in your vocab and grammar. Coming to DM. DM, if you look at it, there are two basically type of questions, ethical based questions and business based questions. Now, XLR is known to be ethical institute. So automatically they will obviously look at that part while selecting the students, and therefore the ethical questions. You need to look at it in the XLR part of it. So the section is based on mix of business and ethics. A little bit logic based questions to do with business, that is there. Best source is the ZAT papers. Pass ZAT paper, look at it and then solve. There is a book, they say ethical, 101 ethical dilemmas. But I don't know how much it has helped students. You can check that out. Try to understand how XLRI would think through a situation. So if you are given a situation, see if you are an XLRI, ethical, see how you can think through that. That's very important. Understanding their way of thinking is very important as far as decision making goes. Problem is, good students normally ignore decision making, and therefore they are unable to clear the cutoff. There's a lot of people are not able to clear the overall cutoff score, very high marks, but unfortunately they falter out here. So suggestion is, do focus on the section. Okay, it can also help you to maximize the scores. If you do really well in decision making, your scores can also shoot overall high. GK not part of cutoffs for exact XLR. So I'm not recommending you to focus too much. It comes later on. There is a weightage, some weightage. But spend less time on it. Don't try to reading newspaper will help, because they're normally current level GKs. Go through the last few years of GK, exact GK, understand the topics which are there in the GK. So from that topic also you can understand what type of questions can come. Mainly go to last 1 year's major news, that will help you for GK, whatever has happened in the past 1 year. So how do you prepare for the exam? So start with writing a mock. So once you have written a mock, get familiar with the different question types which you're not familiar with. For example, maybe in quant, there is median, there is standard deviation, etc. Go through it. Then new sets of DI, go through it. Try to familiarize with that type of questions. In verbal, critical reasoning will be new, try to go through it. Decision making will be completely new, try to go through it. So familiarize with a new type of questions, so you know what type of questions are there. Once you do that, keep writing mocks regularly. But focus on experimenting. Strategy is very important. I'll come with a separate video on strategy, but experimenting is important. 6 to 10 mocks would suffice as far as the examination goes. But focus on experimenting and strategy, and try to get the optimum strategy that is required for your exam. I hope this helps. Thank you.